Hi, hello, and welcome back to our channel. So today in this video, let's discuss about Order 14 fiscal authorization for Italy. So first of all, we have to install the Italy authorization package from Odoo App Store. So let's go to App Store. So here, when you close the apps filter and when you search for Italy. Okay, so here we have two modules. So first one is Italy accounting. So it is for basic accounting features and chart of accounts for the localization. And the next one, that is Italy electronic invoicing. It is for creating, that is implementing electronic invoicing. So first we have to configure the company after installing these modules. So these are already installed and okay. So let's go to settings and create a company. Okay, so here we have six companies. And I have already configured one company. So here we can see general information. Here we can add the address of the company. And house number, door number, then we can add city, then here we can add country and state. Then we can add pin code, zip code. And we can provide some contact details like phone number, email, website. Then you can see when you select the country, automatically currency of the country could be shown here. Okay. Then we can see some extra fields like server PEC, then company PEC mail. Then government PC mail while entering other details. So these are necessary to support the electronic invoicing. So what is actually PEC? PEC means a certified email which is used in Italy. So it is similar to traditional registered email but provides a legal validity for the mail sent. So address will be like your company at pec.mail.it. So later the sender receives some electronic message which certifies the time, date, email address of the recipient, reference and confirmation after having sent the email. So actually it is a tool used for writing and sending official documents for public administration and private companies. Okay, so first one is a server PEC, that is used to configure your PEC email server to send electronic invoices. So the server details will be supplied by the ministry. Then we have company PEC email. So one can add company mail here, PEC mail here, to avail of the electronic invoicing facilities. So this address must be the same address registered with the revenue department. Then government PEC email. So this one where we can add the government PEC email. Okay. Then here we have another field. So this is used to provide fiscal code of your country. Then we can set the tax system. That can be chosen from the drop down list. So here we can see different tax systems. Okay, and here we can provide the VAT number. So make sure that it is in the correct format. Then before configuring the electronic invoicing, so here we can see an additional tab for electronic invoicing as we have installed electronic invoicing for Italy. So before configuring that, we have to make sure of some data that you have given here in general information. So first the PEC server. So it must be the same as the PEC server detail provided by the ministry. Then the company's PEC address. So The one that is registered with the revenue agency for use of electronic invoicing services. Both must be the same. Then for proper working of electronic invoicing, you have to fill the VAT number and tax code correctly. Okay, now let's configure the settings for electronic invoicing. So under this tab, you can find that. So one can enable an option that is company listed on the register of companies. If the vendor is a company listed on the company registry, and as such, the registration details must also be indicated on all documents. Then we can find another option, that is company have a tax representative. So you can enable this option if the vendor is a non-resident entity that carries out VAT relevant transactions in Italy and makes use of a tax representative in Italy. So here we can set the tax representative partner. Okay, now we can save the company. Okay, so the company details, company set. Now, after setting the company, you have to make it active. So you can see here already that company is made active. Now we can just switch to our company, Cybersys Technologies. Okay, now we are in this company. Then let's go to our accounting. Accounting configuration settings. Okay, so here when you search for fiscal country, you can see automatically it is set as Italy. So only tax reports associated with this company, this country, will be available. Okay, and here we can also select the fiscal localization package. So here we can see our Italy generic chart of accounts is available. So select that and save the settings. So according to that, you can see the taxes, fiscal positions, chart of accounts and legal statements for your country. So for this company, you can see the chart of accounts installed, pre-configured. Then we have our taxes for our company. So you can see here, different taxes added. Okay, for this company. Now let's check the customers and see what are additional options, features available in the customer form. So here we have our Azure in detail. Just open that. So some necessary legal information is also added to the customer and vendor forms to use electronic invoicing application properly. So here we can see additional three fields, that is PC email, then you can find tax code, you can set tax code, then PA index. So this PA index is a 6 to 7 character code and is required for electronic invoice communication. Okay. So after providing the correct information, that is these data, we can save this customer and proceed to issue invoice. So when an invoice is sent, the customer will be informed of the status of its delivery. through a pop-up on the beginning of the invoice screen. So the message can be invoice invited, that is waiting for accepting the email, or sending failed when the invoice may be altered and can submit it, can be submitted again, or invoices can be correctly sent, that is show that message will be shown that invoice has been correctly sent and accepted by the recipient. Okay, so that's all about fiscal localization for Italy in Udo 40. If you are interested in knowing more about this or looking for any Udo implementation or customization in your business, drop your request to Udo@cyprosys.com.